Okay, so kunin natin yung discrete time Fourier transform ng x of n equals 2a raised to 3n plus 1 times un plus 2 minus un minus 6. So let's first sketch the graph of the unit step function expression. Kasi ito yung magde-define ng bounds ng discrete time Fourier transform. Okay? So start tayo dito sa first unit step function, un plus 2. Equate natin sa 0 yung argument sa loob. So n plus 2 equals 0. N equals negative 2. So start to sa negative 2 with an amplitude of 1. Papunta sa positive infinity. Okay, ganun din sa un minus 6. Equate natin sa 0. N equals 6. Okay. So, imagine niyo yung un minus 6, itong part na to, minus natin dun sa un plus 2. Okay? So, ang matitira, itong nasa gitna. Yan. So, yung bounds, mag-i-start from negative 2 to positive 6. Ito yung magiging limits nung summation. So, x e to the j omega equals summation n equals negative 2 to positive 6 2a raised to 3n plus 1 times e raised to the negative j omega n. Okay? So, actually, ito na yung sagot, ano? Pwede nyong i-expand. Okay? May index naman yan, ano? But normally, sa mga problems ng discrete time Fourier transform, nire-represent natin to as a geometric series expression. Okay? So, gamitin natin ang geometric series. Kung mapapansin nyo dito sa limang geometric series expression, kamukha niya itong pang-fourth representation. Okay? Kasi ito yung mayroong finite index, mayroong value yung k1, may value din yung upper limit k2. Okay, so ito rin, meron tayong value sa lower limit, negative 2. Meron tayong value sa upper limit, okay, positive 6. So gamitin natin itong expression na ito. Okay, but before that, ayusin muna natin yung mga exponent. Okay, yung mga base tsaka exponent. Pagsama-samahin natin yung mga, may mga parehas, may mga common na exponent. Kung makikita nyo, yung common dito is yung n. Okay? So, paghiwalay natin yung a raised to 3n tsaka yung a raised to 1. So, ilabas natin yung 2 kasi constant lang naman yun. N equals negative 2, positive 6, a raised to 3n times a raised to 1 times e raised to the negative j omega n. Okay? So, itong a, constant lang naman yan. Pwede nyo din ilabas yan. So, 2a summation n equals negative 2 to positive 6. So, a raised to 3, okay, times e raised to the negative j omega, open and close parenthesis, n. Okay, so parehas lang yan. So, itong n, pag minultiply nyo doon, a raised to 3n, itong n, pag minultiply nyo dito sa e raised to the negative j omega, e raised to the negative j omega. Okay? So, itong nasa loob ng parenthesis na to, ito yung pinaka-A doon sa geometric series representation. Okay? So, A raised to K1, 2A, okay, bracket. So, A raised to 3, E to the negative J omega. So, ito, i-raise natin sa K1. Yung K1 natin ay negative 2. Negative 2. Okay. Minus a raised to 3, e to the negative j omega, raised to k2 plus 1. k2 is 6 plus 1, 7. 1 minus a. A raised to 3, e to the negative j omega. So, equals 2a. Distribute natin yung mga exponent dun sa loob. Ito ay a raised to negative 6, e 2j mega minus a raised to 21 e negative 7 j omega 1 minus a raised to 3 e to the negative j omega. Yung a sa labas, i-distribute natin sa loob. So, 2. So, a raised to 1. Ito, a raised to 1 times a raised to negative 6. So, equals to a 1 minus 6 a raised to negative 5. So, negative 5 e 2j omega. Ganun din dito. Ito naman ay a raised to 1 times a raised to 21. So, a raised to 22 e negative 7j omega divided by 1 minus a raised to 3 e to the negative j omega. Okay, so pwede pa ba natin itong i-simplify? Actually, pwede pa, no? Kasi may mga negative na exponents. So, pwede natin gawing itong a raised to negative 5. So, parehas yan ng a raised to 5. Okay, ito rin. E to the negative 7j omega, ito ay equal sa 1 over e 7j omega. So, simplify pa natin further. So, 1 over a raised to 5 times e raised to 2j omega a raised to 22 times 1 over e raised to 7j omega. Sa baba, may negative din yung e raised to negative j omega. So, 1 minus a cube over e j omega. Okay, so simplify pa natin further. Pwede pa to. So, 2j omega 5th 22 over e 7j omega divided by ito, pag sinimplify natin to, e to the j omega minus a cube divided by e to the j omega. So, e to the j omega minus a cube divided by e to the j omega. Simplify pa natin yung numerator. Malapit na to. So, 2. Cross-multiply natin. So, ito ay e. Pag in-add natin yung exponent, 9j omega minus, ganun din dito, a raised to 27 divided by common denominator. Least common denominator, a raised to 5 times e raised to 7j omega divided by e j omega minus a cube divided by e raised to j omega. Reciprocal natin itong baba. Okay, ito. I think last two steps na to. E raised to 9 j omega minus a raised to 27 divided by a raised to 5 times e 7 j omega times, okay, reciprocal natin, e j omega j omega minus a cube. So, mayroon ba tayong pwedeng i-cancel? I think mayroon, ano? Kasi itong e raised to j omega, mayroon din dito. So, ito matitira na lang dito ay 6j omega. Yan. Kasi itong e raised to j omega, pag binaba nyo yan, I think hindi na pala, ano? Kasi itong e raised to j omega divided by 7j. Ah, okay, tama. E j omega times e negative 7j omega. Lagay natin dito. Negative 7j omega. So, tama. E to the negative 6j omega. 1 over e to the 6j omega. So, tama. So, may matitira dito ang e to the 6j omega. Okay? So, I think ito na yun. Ayusin lang natin, ano? So, 2 e to the 9j omega minus a raised to 27 divided by a raised to 5 e 6 j omega, okay, times e j omega minus a cube. Okay? So, ito yung pinaka-simplified na sagot natin. Ano? Ito yung discrete time Fourier transform ng 2a raised to 3n plus 1. Okay? So, medyo mahaba yung simplification niya. No? But for me, kahit hanggang dito lang siguro pwede na. No? I think ito. Yan. For me, okay na to. Okay, basta ma-represent nyo siya as a geometric series. Kasi pag ito lang, pwede naman. Pwede nyo siyang i-expand, but masyadong simple yung sagot. Okay, and sinabi ko nga kanina, normally yung mga sagot sa discrete time Fourier transform is naka-represent by using geometric series. Okay? So, yun. I hope na-gets yung mga techniques, no? So, algebra lang naman ito at saka mga rules of base and exponents. So, pakirecall yung part na yun.